Hi everybody, it's Ingrid from Twinkl, and today we're going to be talking about pie charts. Pie chart is a circular graph that is divided into sections. The size of these sections is directly proportional to the size of the data that they represent. It gets its name from its appearance, which resembles a pie that has been cut into differently sized pieces. Let's take a look at some data and how it can be represented in a pie chart. In the survey, 40 people were asked to identify their favorite color. Their options were blue, red, green, yellow, and other. This same data represented in a pie chart would look like this. As you can see, the sections of a pie chart represent a percentage of a whole. The size of each section is proportional to the size of the percentage. The larger sections of a pie chart represent the people who voted blue or other, as those are the groups that had the most people in them. The smallest section, yellow, is the smallest because only 5% of the people polled said that their favorite color was yellow. Each section of a pie chart is labeled, so you can associate each section with the data that it represents. Usually, the different sections of a pie chart are also differentiated by color, so you can easily tell which one is which. Pie charts are handy because they give you an immediate visual representation of your data. They're easy to understand, as the differently colored sections make it instantly obvious how they compare to each other. When deciding how to present your data, consider how many categories you want to include. The rule of thumb for pie charts is to use under 6 categories. This will keep your charts accessible and easy to understand. If you use too many categories, it makes it more difficult to see the proportional difference between the different groups of data. If you're working with more than 6 categories, consider using a bar chart instead. Overall, pie charts are great because they're easy to digest and get the information you need at a glance. The bigger the slice of pie, the bigger the percentage. They're also really widely used and understood, which makes them very accessible. So what are the different types of pie charts? There is one variation to the pie chart, which we showed previously, that uses a similar means of displaying data. This is called a doughnut chart, which is named after the circular and also delicious foodstuff. Doughnut charts operate much in the same way as pie charts, with each section representing a percentage. They differ in the sense that a doughnut chart has a big hole in the middle, whereas a pie chart does not. If you enjoyed learning about pie charts, you might also be interested in some of our data and statistics resources. There are plenty of great activities, worksheets, and PowerPoints on the Twinkl website for teaching learners about these topics, so make sure you take a look if you're interested. That's all for now, but thank you so much for watching and have a lovely day.